Hi everyone, these two GPUs are from NVIDIA. This one is the Aorus RTX 3060 Ti, and this one is the Zotac Gaming Trinity RTX 4070 Ti. In this video, I'll be comparing the performance of these two GPUs from the content creation point of view to see if the RTX 4070 Ti will give me much better performance than the RTX 3060 Ti. So I will be performing a series of tests to compare both results. I'll be using, for instance, Adobe Premiere Pro to export 4K videos. I'll use also Blender to render an image and so on. So I will start by unboxing the Zotac Gaming Trinity GPU 4070 Ti to show you what's in the box. And then I'll install it in my PC that have a PCIe Gen 4 motherboard and is running an AMD Ryzen 7 5800X processor. So let's bring the camera up close and unbox the Zotac Gaming GPU. So these are a user manual and some labels that you can put on your PC. And this is a support bracket so that the GPU doesn't fall. And this is a power cable. And this is a GPU. Looks nice. And this is where it goes and the PC. Start the installation by connecting the power cable. You need 3 8-pin connectors, and these are the 3 8-pin connectors from my PSU. By the way, my PSU is 650 watts, and this is supposed to be sufficient for this GPU. I'm gonna test it for a week and let you know if it was sufficient and if it was stable. So now I have the power connected. And this is where the GPU should go. This is a PCIe 16X Gen 4 slot in my PC. So let's install the GPU. And this is the GPU installed. Let's connect the power to it. And you need to put the screws here. As you see, the GPU has one HDMI port and three display ports. And now let me show you how to install the support for the GPU. So this is a good place for the support. Otherwise, it's gonna touch the fans. So loosen the screw here and hold the support like this. Push the screw and then tighten it. So this is the PC's first start after installing the GPU. It looks really nice. Let's go and perform the tests now. The first test I'm doing is with Blender. I'm rendering the classroom scene. I used OptiX acceleration and only GPU compute. And here the RTX 4070 Ti crushed the RTX 3060 Ti. It finished the rendering in 11.4 seconds, whereas the RTX 3060 Ti finished the rendering in 23.58 seconds. And this is more than double the speed for the RTX 4070 Ti. So now I am exporting an Adobe Premiere Pro 2023, a 4K video that is 9 minutes 26 seconds, and I'm using GPU acceleration. And you notice that Adobe Premiere Pro, when it's exporting a video, doesn't use fully the GPU. So both GPUs were only used at about 35% from their full capacity. And here there's a slight advantage for the RTX 4070 Ti. It was averaging 86 frames per second, whereas the RTX 3060 Ti was averaging 84 frames per second. In this test, I'm performing the Furmark benchmark. And this shows the video rendering capability of each GPU. And here you notice that the 4070 Ti is performing very well. And in 4K, it achieved 143 frames per second and it had a score of 8,561, whereas the 3060 Ti managed only 61 frames per second and it achieved the score of 3,679. In this test, I'm using VSDC. This is the video software editing that I use to export a 4K video that is 9 minutes 26 seconds. And here, just like Adobe Premiere Pro, the gain for the 4070 Ti is almost negligible. It is only 1 frame per second faster than the 3060 Ti. It is exporting at a speed of 34 frames per second, whereas the 3060 Ti was exporting at a speed of 33 frames per second. And here, of course, I'm using the GPU acceleration to perform this export. So you saw that the 4070 Ti won over the 3060 Ti in all the tests, but not all the results were like a clear advantage for the 4070 Ti. So in all the tests that performed
graphics rendering, the 4070 Ti crushed the 3060 Ti, and it was almost double the speed than the 3060 Ti. When it came to video exporting, both GPUs performed almost the same, with a very slight and negligible advantage to the 4070 Ti that was faster in 1 or 2 frames per second only over the 3060 Ti. The reason that the rendering was much faster than the exporting of videos is that with the rendering engine, the usage of the GPU was almost 100% all the time, whereas in the exporting of videos, the usage of the GPU rarely went beyond 35%. Now, when it comes to the subjective experience of using both GPUs, and I've been using the 4070 Ti for about 10 days now, and the 3060 Ti I had it for almost 2 years now. So with the 4070 Ti, the whole like video editing experience was much smoother and much faster than with the 3060 Ti. You know, when you reposition clips and when you cut clips and the time it takes for the image to render on your screen, the 4070 Ti was really much faster and the experience was much smoother than with the 3060 Ti. And this by itself is a motive to upgrade to the 4070 Ti, and I'm keeping the 4070 Ti and I like it very much. At the beginning of this video, I told you that I will tell you if my power supply, that is 650 watts, can support the 4070 Ti. And I can tell you that even when using the GPU at 100%, you saw that in the rendering tests, the GPU was being used at 100%. And I also did some gaming on it, and my system was very stable. And the 650 watts PSU supported without any problem the 4070 Ti GPU. By the way, if you want to check out this Zotac Gaming Trinity 4070 Ti GPU, I'm going to leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.